Hello everyone, welcome to our chapter Principles of Inheritance and Variations. So in this episode we are discussing the NCERT questions. Okay, so after this class you must write down the notes about these questions. So the first question is, mention the advantages of selecting P plan for experiment by Mendel. We know that Mendel chose P plan. Okay, so P plan having so many advantages. It's having short life cycle and large number of true breeding varieties are available. Okay, so that are the main features why the Mendel chose P plan. Next question, differentiate between the following: dominant and recessive. Dominant means that which character is expressing, that is dominant, and which character is suppressive, that is recessive. Homozygous, what is homozygous? Homozygous means if the both allele of a gene are similar, then the individual is called homozygous. When both allele of a gene are dissimilar, then the individual is called heterozygous. Capital T and small t, that is in a homozygous condition. Capital T, small t, that is in heterozygous condition. Okay. Next is monohybrid and dihybrid. Okay, so a monohybrid means the cross between two individuals having single contrasting trait or character at a time, that is monohybrid. If you are selecting two contrasting traits, it is known as dihybrid cross. Okay, so please be open your textbook, otherwise you can follow me. Third question, a diploid organism is heterozygous for four loci. How many types of gametes can be produced? So the equation for founding the gamete is 2 raised to n. So here given 4 loci. So 2 raised to n. So here n is the 4. So 2 raised to 4 means 16 gametes are available. Next question, explain the law of dominance using monohybrid cross. What is law of dominance? You know that Mendel proposed 3 laws. Okay, the first law is law of dominance. Law of dominance states that when two different allelomorphic genes are present in an organism, only one express itself in F1 generation, that is monohybrid cross, and you design the monohybrid cross. Next question is, define and design a test cross. What is test cross? Test cross means a cross in which an individual with an unknown dominant phenotype is crossed with recessive individual for the trait, that is known as test cross. Okay, the test cross ratio is 1:1. Design means you draw the hybrid chart of the test cross. Next question, using a Punnett square, work out the distribution of phenotypic features in the first filial generation after a cross between homozygous female and a heterozygous male. Here clearly they are given that the female is homozygous. Okay, so we can take capital T or small t. And next they give heterozygous male. So capital T, small t. For using this, make a cross between all this. Next question is, when a cross is made between tall plant with yellow seed and tall plant with red green seed, what proportions of phenotype in the offsprings could be expected to be tall and green, dwarf and green? Okay, so we have to find out tall and green population and dwarf and green population. They give on the tall plant and yellow plant in a heterozygous condition. Okay, so it is not following dihybrid cross ratio. So we are getting in another ratio. I gave you the ratio number. Tall green is 3:8. You work out and find out. You will be get this proportion or not. Tall green ratio is 3:8 and dwarf green ratio is 1:8. Okay, dwarf means it is a recessive one. Next question, two heterozygous parents are crossed. If the two loci are linked, what would be the distribution of phenotypic features in F1 generation for a dihybrid cross? Okay, so here the two loci are linked. So that is our clue. If two loci are linked, then there would be no segregation and the F1 generation will exhibit parental characteristics only. But if the two loci are incompletely linked, then segregation would occur partially and the F1 generation will exhibit both parental and recombinant characteristics. But the recombinants will be in a very less proportion. Okay. Next question is, briefly mention the contribution of T.H. Morgan in genetics. Who is T.H. Morgan? T.H. Morgan proposed linkage. Okay, linkage. He proposed a linkage. He conducted his work in Drosophila melanogaster. Okay, Drosophila, otherwise known as fruit fly. And he stated that the genes are located on the chromosomes, and also the principles of linkage, crossing over, sex linked inheritance, and discovered the relationship between the genes and the chromosome. Clear it is? Next is, what is pedigree analysis? Suggest how such analysis can be useful. So what is pedigree? What is pedigree analysis means? What? A record of inheritance of certain genetic traits for two or more generations present in the form of a diagram or a family tree. Okay, that is known as pedigree analysis. We are using different type of symbols in pedigree analysis. So through the pedigree analysis, we can find it, easily find out which type of inheritance or which type of trait is passing. Okay, so the pedigree analysis is mainly used for the for studying a specific trait or abnormality or a disease like that. For population studies also, this pedigree chart is using. Clear? Then how is sex determined in human beings? How is sex determined in human beings? So we know that there are three main type of sex determination. So in case of humans, XX female and XY male. So there is an equal chance for getting a male child and a female child. Okay, so asking this type of questions, you must show the cross between the male and female. Next question, a child has a blood group O. If the father has a blood group A, mother had a blood group B, work out the genotype of the parents and the possible genotype of the offspring. Okay, here the baby's blood group is O and the parents are A blood group and the B blood group. If you are taking or crossing the parents' blood group in the homozygous condition, we will not get the O blood group baby. So here we are taking the blood group of the parents in a heterozygous form. That means A group represented as IAI0 and the B group represented as IBI0. We already did this type of questions. Okay. So we are getting O blood group babies. Next question is, explain the following terms. Codominance. What is codominance? The F1 generation resembles both the parents and both the parental characters are expressed simultaneously. Okay, simultaneously. That phenomenon is known as codominance. The next is incomplete dominance. Incomplete dominance means there's not showing the dominant character or phenotype, that means recessive character, showing in another or combination of the character. So incomplete dominance is shown in Mirabilis jalapa or Andridium snapdragon. Okay, and the ratio is not a monohybrid ratio, it will change from the normal monohybrid ratio. Here they get the ratio is 1:2, 2:1. Next question is, what is point mutation? Give one example. What is point mutation? Point mutation means the mutation which occurs in a single base pair. Single, that is very important. Single base pair, that is known as point mutation. Okay, so example for this point mutation is PKU is an example. What is PKU? Phenylketonuria. Okay, and sickle cell anemia. In case of sickle cell anemia, the sixth position of beta globin gene get altered. So what will happen in GAG? GAG stands for glutamic acid. Here what will happen? The mutation occurs. So glutamic acid is not producing here. Here producing another amino acid valine. So the RBC losing his disc shape and get into the sickle shape. So when the RBC changes into sickle shape, it reduces the oxygen carrying capacity. Next question, who had proposed the chromosomal theory of inheritance? Who had proposed the chromosomal theory of inheritance? Chromosomal theory of inheritance was proposed by Sutton and Bowery the year 1902. Okay. Next question, mention any two autosomal genetic disorders with their symptoms. Any two autosomal genetic disorders with their symptoms. Okay, so autosomal genetic disorders means the disorders which will affect on the autosomes only. Okay, so we discussed different types of autosomal disorders. Here just given two examples. So I am suggesting you Down syndrome and phenylketonuria. Okay, you can write sickle cell anemia also. So what is Down syndrome? Down syndrome is a trisomy 21 condition. and pineal gland aneurysm is an inborn error of metabolism. Okay, so in case of pineal gland aneurysm, the liver doesn't produce the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. So the conversion of phenylalanine to tyrosine was not take place. Okay, it will lead to the accumulation of the phenylalanine to our body. So the derivatives also accumulated in the brain and it causes mental retardation. All these we have discussed in our lecture classes. Okay, so other example is Down syndrome, that is a trisomy 21, and other Klinefelter's trisomy 18. Petamo syndrome, trisomy 15, and sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia, what will happen here? The normal RBC shape get changed into sickle shape. So the oxygen carrying capacity will be decreasing. Okay, and led to the anemia. Okay, so these are the 16 NCERT textbook back questions. So you must write down these questions with answers in your notebook and send it to me. Clear it us? Hello everyone, welcome to our chapter, Principles of